Welcome to the Indie Film Hustle Podcast, episode number 320. A negative mind will never give you a positive life. Mongo Wilder.
Broadcasting from the back alley in Hollywood, it's the Indie Film Hustle Podcast, where we show you how to survive and thrive as an indie filmmaker in the jungles of the film biz. And here's your host, Alex Ferrari.
Welcome, my Indie Film Hustlers, to another episode of the Indie Film Hustle Podcast. I am your humble host, Alex Ferrari. Today's show is sponsored by Black Box. Black Box is a new platform and community that is all about financial freedom for filmmakers like you. If you join Black Box, you will be transformed from being a worker to being a maker of your own content. And you'll be making steady passive income from the global market. Black Box currently allows you to upload your stock footage once, get it to many global agencies, and then allows you to share that passive income stream with your collaborators. Whether you want to submit old footage that's been sitting around in your hard drives or create brand new content, Black Box is for you. It's really quite revolutionary. With Black Box, filmmakers can concentrate on making great content while Black Box takes care of all the business BS. Just visit www.blackbox.global to find out more. Now, guys, I want to ask you a question. Do you have an idea for a film that can change the world? Would you like to be mentored by a working Hollywood professional? What do you think about $10,000 to make, write, shoot, and direct your own short film? If any of these sound like something that you have or you want, then Telenexus Script Filmmaking Lab is for you. This contest awards $10,000 for you to write, shoot, and direct your own short film. And you will get to work with an industry mentor to help you bring your film to life. And unlike other contests, there are no fees. It is free to submit. So I have no idea what you guys are waiting for. After you finish listening to this podcast, go and submit right now. So don't wait. Apply now. Stop talking about making a movie and go make a movie. Someone is going to get $10,000 and a Hollywood mentor. Why not you? And as a special reward, mention Indie Film Hustle referred you and the application will receive special consideration for tribe members. Just head over to indiefilmhustle.com/make-your-movie-now. That's indiefilmhustle.com/make-your-movie-now. So before we get started, guys, I want to let you know I'm going to be up at the Brave Maker Film Festival in Redwood, California, screening the last public screening of On the Corner of Ego and Desire, my film I shot at Sundance, on Saturday, June 1st at 5 p.m. And then I'm going to be doing a talk on Sunday, June 2nd at 2 p.m., about the book, about breaking through your fears and making your first feature film, and also about shooting for the mob and other things as well. We'll be doing a book signing and a Q&A and all that kind of good stuff on that day as well. So please, if you guys are up in the area, I'd love to see the tribe come out and represent on both things. If you can, come to the screening for the Q&A and also for the speech or the keynote that I'm going to be giving as well, which will be held in the legendary courtroom that they shot Mrs. Doubtfire in, if you can believe it. It's going to be a great weekend. So I'd love for you guys to come out. For tickets, head over to indiefilmhustle.com/screening, and it'll take you right to the tickets page. And you get a special discount because you are, of course, a tribe member. So all you have to do is type in the code Brave Maker Film Fest IFH 2019, and that gives you 20% off the screening of Ego and Desire and my keynote talk on Sunday. So again, that code is Brave Maker Film Fest IFH 2019. I hope to see you guys there. So guys, today I have a question for you. Are you a hater? Are you someone who hates on other people's successes? When you see an article or a post or a podcast or a video about someone else's, another filmmaker's, another screenwriter's success in this business, does your immediate feeling about it be a one of hate? Being one of, oh, well, they got this, that, or they had this opportunity or that opportunity, and that's why they succeeded? If you are, then I hate to tell you, my friend, but you're a hater. And I wanted to talk a little bit about this because a few weeks ago, I released an episode about Jonathan Perry, a very young film director who's 17 and got an Amazon Studios deal. Actually, he's the youngest film director ever to get a deal with a streaming service, let alone Amazon Studios, off of an unfinished short film. And though it was an extremely popular podcast, a lot of people loved it. A lot of people were really happy with Jonathan. I did see in comments and posts and things like that, a lot of haterade going on. Just a lot of people out there just hating on Jonathan's success. And it wasn't anything personal with Jonathan. It was just the mere fact of his story. It happened a little bit before when I talked about Kansas Bowling. She was a 17-year-old film director who shot a feature film on 16mm and sold it to distribution when she was still 17. And there was a lot of hate back then as well. And I just kind of realized, oh, and by the way, there's been hate on many episodes. The Range 15 guys, when they made $3 million off of their movie and their whole story, I would see a little bit of hate here and there, but I got a real big wave of the hate off of that one podcast from a few weeks ago with Jonathan. So I said, I think this is something that needs to be addressed, because I think it's not only a problem for the people being hated on, but I think it's even a larger problem for the people who are hating. Now, I always tell people when I speak publicly, I always ask them, we all know angry and bitter filmmakers. And if you don't know any angry and bitter filmmakers, you are the angry and bitter filmmaker. Now, I'm going to tell you a little bit about my history of hating, okay? Because I am not immune to this. I was an angry and bitter filmmaker for so many years. If you guys read my book, Shooting for the Mob, you'll understand where a lot of that hate came from. Being so close to your dream, having it literally inches away from your face and getting it pulled away like it did in that time of my life, made me very angry, made me very bitter for over 15 years. Easily. And to add more to that, you know, I was in post-production. So as a post guy, an editor, a colorist, post supervisor, I would work with many filmmakers. And every single time I would get a young, you know, filmmaker who was in his early 20s, who had never directed a feature film, and someone gave him $2 or $3 million, you know, I was there to help them, you know, bring their vision to life. But underneath it all, there was hate, man. There was just this anger and bitterness towards their success, because I would always say to myself, well, why didn't that happen to me? I have as much, if not more, talent and experience as that filmmaker. Why didn't I get the shot? Why didn't someone show up at my door with $1 million or $2 million or $3 million to go make a feature film? Why am I not getting mine? And that was my mentality. That was the mentality that held me back for so long in my life. I want you to understand something. That success is a result of your thinking. Success is a result of your work. And success is a result of your hustle. It's cause and effect. This is what the universe is made out of. Cause and effect. Cause of your success or cause of your failure is up to you. Your failure to achieve your goals in this business are a direct result of what's going on underneath, inside of you. Whatever results you're getting in your life or in your career, whether good or bad, remember, your outer world is a reflection of your inner world. If you're hating on people, if you're leaving comments on Facebook and Twitter and YouTube and anywhere else on the internet, it says a lot more about who you are than about who you are hating upon. I really, truly believe that. I truly believe that whatever you're putting out into the universe will come back to you in one way, shape, or form. Whether it's that manifestation of a lack in your career, in your dream, in what you're trying to achieve in this business or in life, I do truly believe that what you do put out does come back to you. So if you're hating on people and you're asking yourself, wow, I'm really, really not getting to where I want to be. Let me ask you a question. Do you think that David Fincher, Christopher Nolan, Steven Spielberg, Steven Soderbergh, do you think any of these guys are sitting around hating on other people? Do you think any of them are truly spending, exerting any mental energy on hating on other people, on being bitter about someone else's success? Now, I know a lot of you are saying right now, and if you're saying this, this is a perfect reason why you should be listening to this podcast. If you're saying right now, well, Alex, that's Steven Spielberg. He's one of the greatest filmmakers of all time. He's rich. He's super, super successful. He has many Oscars. Why would he be hating on anybody? If you think that, then you should be listening to this podcast. Because I promise you, when Steven was not a billionaire and was not one of the most successful filmmakers of all time, I promise you, he was not sitting down thinking about why somebody else was getting an opportunity and he didn't. He was too busy making his own opportunities. He was too busy hustling. He was too busy working and being creative and creating content, creating movies, creating opportunities for himself, rather than just think about what I don't have because someone else took it. That mentality is what's going to hold you back, and it is holding you back. It held me back for almost 20 years of my life. And when I finally let go of it, I can't tell you the freedom, and I can't tell you the things that have happened in my life. In every forest, in every farm, anywhere in the world, it is what you can't see that creates what you can see. It is the seeds and the roots that create the reality that we can perceive in our eyes. They have to be there. The seeds and the deep roots have to be there before you see a mighty sequoia or an oak tree. The magic that happens underneath that ground, that things that we can't perceive by our naked eye, is what the magic is of creating those things. And that, those seeds and those roots that I'm talking about, is your mind, is your thoughts. I truly, truly, truly think that using powers that you can't see is the most powerful thing you have to achieve your dreams, to achieve your goals in life. Your mindset, your thinking, the programming that you're putting inside of you, the habits that you're creating inside of you. And I know some of you are saying, Alex, what are you talking about, things you can't see? How can I use something I can't see? Well, you use electricity, don't you? Every day, your entire life revolves around the use of electricity. Though we can't see it, can you? If you do see it, run. But generally, we don't see electricity. But it powers our homes, it powers our cars, it powers our computers, it powers our entire way of life. But yet it is something we can't see or can't feel, generally speaking. And if you don't believe that electricity is a power that runs your entire world, try sticking your finger in a socket. You're going to figure out real quick that it's there. Don't, please, disclaimer, don't stick your finger in a socket. It's just an analogy, guys. But using those powers, using those things, that your mindset, your thinking, the programming, the habits that you create to achieve your dreams is more powerful than anything you can see. When you hate on someone else's success, you end up hurting your own success. What you focus on expands. If you expand on negativity, then that is what's going to come back to you. If you are focusing only negative things, on bitterness, on anger in your life, then that is what you're going to get more of in your life. When I changed the way I started thinking about my life, about being angry at other filmmakers or other people's successes in every aspect of my life, it was even back in the day when I saw a guy with a beautiful girl and go, why does he have a beautiful girlfriend and I don't? It was that mentality of lack, that mentality that I can't do that because someone else has it. That mentality is deadly. And when I released it finally, and I'll just talk about how I released it in my professional career. When I just stopped hating on other people's successes and stopped being bitter and angry, I made my first feature film. I made This Is Meg. And the second I made the decision to make my first feature and did not hate as much or at all at other people's successes, then things started opening up. The second I made that decision, and it was quick, guys. It was very, very quick. I just made the choice. And from that point on, amazing, amazing things have happened to me. You guys have been listening to me for a while, so you know there's been a lot of wonderful successes that happened in my life and many wonderful things that are happening in my life. Hell, I get to do this full time. You know, this is my full-time job helping filmmakers, helping the tribe in one way, shape, or form, putting out content there that inspires them, that moves them forward, that educates them while I'm educating myself and inspiring myself on a daily basis. I'm living my dream and I'm so, so grateful for it. But I don't wake up in the morning thinking, well, why does that website have more followers than I do? Or why does that podcast maybe get more listens than I do? I did. Don't get me wrong. I'm not perfect. I did think that way, but I stopped. I stopped. Because at the end of the day, it doesn't do me any good. And I promise you, it won't do any good for you. And it isn't doing any good for you. I challenge you for the next 30 days not to hate on anyone. Not to hate on anyone else's successes. When you read a story in the news or on Variety or on Facebook or wherever, I want you to consciously not hate on them. And for God's sakes, please don't leave any negative remarks or comments about someone else's success. Oh, well, he just got this or he just got that. I challenge you for 30 days not to hate on people. Don't hate on the Russo brothers for making Avengers Endgame and making $350 gazillion on opening weekend. Don't hate on the 17-year-old filmmaker who got signed to Amazon off of an unfinished short film. Not anyone. Do not hate on anyone. Do not be bitter about anyone else's success. Do not be angry about anyone else's success. And if you do that for 30 days, I want you guys to please email me, message me, tweet at me, whatever, tag me on a post. Let me know what happens in your life. Let me know if there's been any change, any movement at all. Because I promise you, if you make that small little switch, something might not be huge, not going to get a huge giant thing. Maybe you will, maybe you won't. A huge opportunity is going to show up on your front door. But I promise you that you'll feel better. You'll probably have a little bit more energy to put towards something positive. Maybe learn a little bit more. Maybe work a little bit harder on the things that you want to do. But I promise you that. So challenge yourselves for the next 30 days not to be bitter or angry or hate on anybody else's success. And let me know how it goes for you guys. I wanted to do this episode because I really felt that it was something important to talk about. And again, I don't hear anybody else talking about things like this. So I said, you know what? I think this is something that needs to be addressed. I think this is going to help the tribe because damn it, man, it helped me. It helped me so, so much. And I promise you, I was one of the angriest and bitterest filmmakers you would ever meet. I was so angry. So if this isn't you and you aren't an angry and bitter filmmaker, talk to the bitter filmmaker that you do know, the angry filmmaker. Send him or her this podcast and maybe it will help them. Maybe it will give them a different point of view. I don't know. Maybe they'll start hating on me for doing this podcast. It's okay. I don't mind. I can take it. I'm just trying to help and I'm just trying to to help the tribe and help to anyone who decides to listen to this stuff that I'm putting out there in the world. So I hope this episode helps you guys. I really, really do. I've got a couple of books that I'm going to put in the show notes at indiefilmhustle.com/319. And hopefully they'll help you out a little bit. These books have helped me out a bunch. So hopefully they'll help you out a little bit on your journey to be a less bitter and angry filmmaker. But I do promise you guys something, man. If you don't change that mentality, if you don't focus on things that are positive, things that you're grateful for, things that you will move you forward and towards what you want in life, you're never going to get out of where you're at. That I promise you, because man, I didn't move barely anything for 20 years. It took me a long time to figure this out. But the second I did, the second I made that switch, my entire life changed. So I hope I can make that change for you guys. I hope that this episode does that for you. Thank you for listening so, so much, guys. I truly appreciate it. If you haven't already, please head over to filmmakingpodcast.com and leave a good review for this podcast on iTunes. It really, really, really helps us out in the rankings and getting this information out to as many filmmakers and screenwriters as humanly possible. Thank you guys again so much for your support. I truly, truly appreciate it. As always, keep that hustle going. Keep that dream alive. Stop hating. And I'll talk to you soon.
Thanks for listening to the Indie Film Hustle Podcast at IndieFilmHustle.com. That's IndieFilmHustle.com.